بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In this video I'm going to talk about the impact of changes in the inspiratory time in a pressure controlled ventilation in a patient with controlled mandatory ventilation. In another way, does a change in the tidal volume have an impact or effect on the esophageal pressure? Let's go and see. This patient with the same data, I'm not going to change any except the inspiratory time and see the effect of impact of change in the inspiratory time to make a change in the tidal volume and its impact of on the esophageal pressure. In this case, in this patient, the time here is one second. And these are the data. This is the esophageal time curve. This is the esophageal pressure. This is the peak inspiratory pressure. This is the flow, tidal volume, transfer of pressure. So this is the tidal volume. This is inspiratory flow, expiratory flow, esophageal pressure, transfer pressure, inspiration, expiration, and the strain. We calculated the strain. This patient with inspiratory time 1 second. When you look at the inspiratory flow, the inspiratory flow does not come to the, or didn't come to the zero point. This means disturbing pressure needs a higher tidal volume. The predicted tidal volume should be larger than this. When you increase the inspiratory time to 1.2, look at this. This also, these are the data. And also the inspiratory flow didn't come to zero. Although this is a tidal volume increase, the same inspiratory flow, expiratory flow, esophageal pressure here, this is measured, increased, transfer pressure 12, and the strain calculated is 0.9. When we increased, this is time, the same living pressure, same data, time only increased to 2.4. Look at this, 2.4. Here we are left with inspiratory flow. This means that this time is sufficient for the delivery of the predicted tidal volume. So the tidal volume increase, this is a maximum. If we increase more than this, no increase in the tidal volume. We will increase only the inspiratory flows. So this is the tidal volume for this predicted driving pressure. This is inspiratory flow, expiratory flow, esophageal pressure, transfer pressure, doing inspiration, expiration, and this is the strain. Let's come and compare. So this is the tidal volume with 1 second, 1.2 second increased, 2.4 second increased. So this increase in the tidal volume, no change in the flow, but this concomitant increase in the esophageal pressure. Although the driving pressure the same, airway pressure the same, no change in the airway pressure. But so the transalveolar pressure at the end of inspiration sure decreased. It's fixed the airway pressure all through. Increase in the esophageal pressure will be decrease in the transalveolar pressure. Increasing the tidal volume was associated here with decrease and the strain. How does it come? So this is a bind. When we come to the formula, esophageal pressure equals airway pressure multiplied by the elastance of the chest wall over the total elastance. So the esophageal pressure will depend on airway pressure, lung compliance or elastance, chest wall compliance, and abdominal pressure, because lessons of chest wall depends on the abdomen. This is a formula correlation between the two. So these are the four items which determine the esophageal pressure. But in this case, when you come to see that the tidal volume itself has an effect on the esophageal pressure, although this was fixed. So the change only the tidal, increase in the tidal volume was associated with increases in the esophageal pressure. So this is a very important point. So this should be added. This means that the increase in the esophageal pressure in the presence of these fixed data will be due to an increase in the lung volume. The second point, there was an increase in the tidal volume but with concomitant decrease in the strain. How does it come? If you come to the formula, this is transalveolar pressure equals the specific one, which is fixed, or 13, multiplied by the tidal volume over the functional residual capacity. Decreasing this means that there should be increase in the functional residual capacity. So there was an increase in the tidal volume, which concomitant increase in the functional residual capacity. That's why the strain of the strain was decreasing. So we can say that the esophageal pressure is affected by airway pressure, the lung compliance, chest compliance, abdominal pressure, and the tidal volume. Thank you.